Let's give God a hand of praise. Are you happy to be in the house of the Lord?
Yeah.
Amen. It's always joy and pleasure to be in the house of the Lord. Amen. Let us just pray so that we can do the wedding. I'd invite you to sit down. Hallelujah. Let's bow our heads. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you once again this evening. Lord, just to be in the house, Lord, is just wonderful. The atmosphere that has been prepared by your Spirit. Father God, the excitement and the joy and the anticipation to receive from you and hear from you. Lord, is just joy in our hearts, Lord. Father God, we are tired from the toils of the day, the toils of the week. But Lord, we know that when we're in our house, Heavenly Father, there's no better place to be. Father God, even this evening we came with different needs, different desires. And Father, I pray that may all of them be addressed by your word. Because you know we know the faces, we hear the voices. But Lord, you know the intents of the heart, O Lord. You know every man's thought. You know everyone by name. You know the amount of everyone's heart, head. Father, we know everything about us because you created us. And Father, we thank you that you identified and revealed yourself to us. And Father, we thank you that you put it upon our heart also to accept you by faith. And even this evening, Lord, we say, come down, the Holy Spirit. Lord, at work, we're led by men, societies, in our communities, but Lord, we want true leadership in their lives.
Hallelujah.
Father God, because man's knowledge comes to naught and is limited. But Lord Jesus, your wisdom is amazing. Father God, some of the things that you created, even Solomon, when he looked at them, he could not understand them. He said that things that I look at and I could not, that are wonderful and I don't understand. He said the movement of an eagle in the air. Father God, and we thank you that you loved us so much this evening that you will send a messenger to come and reveal these things to us.
Hallelujah.
Even the things that the great man Solomon never understood, we understand.
Amen.
That's why we are whole most responsible, because no mysteries, nothing is hidden. You reveal yourself to your bride.
Hallelujah.
We thank you, Father. May you come down, Lord, and take preeminence. Speak to the children of your heart. I'm a man, I'm a failure. But Lord, you are not a failure. You are not a man. May you be the one addressing the hearts of your children, their needs, their desires, their weaknesses, their failures. Lord, may you address them through the preaching of your word. And when we leave this place, we will surely say, we might not be what we want to be. We might not be what we ought to be. But surely we are not what we used to be. Because the way changes us every day.
Hallelujah.
Father, we dedicate this word into your hands. May you move me out of the picture, O Lord. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we thank you. Amen. Let's open our Bibles from the book of Deuteronomy. Thank you. Give it to heaven. To the sons of Adam, he said the bounds of the people according to the number of the children of Israel. For the Lord's portion is his people.
Amen.
Jacob is the Lord of his inheritance. He found him in desert land and in the waste, howling wilderness. He led him about, he instructed him, he kept him as the apple of his eye.
Amen.
As an eagle stirreth up her nest, fluttereth over her young, spreadeth abroad her wings, taketh them, beareth them on her wings. So the Lord alone did lead him, and there was no strange God with him. You may be seated.
Amen.
A soldier is someone whose soul to die. Soldier, I remember one pastor Denzel, my pastor in Grimstown, he broke the word soldier into two pieces one day. He says soldier is combination of two words, sold and dire. So is someone who sold his soul to die for something. Hallelujah. Natural soldiers sold their souls to die for the country. Hallelujah. That's why when they say go, there you go. When they say do this, you do. Amen.
Amen.
And in the army, there's this thing, you comply and you complain later. Amen.
Amen.
So I just want to take a short title. As the eagle started her nest. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I was pondering around this and you know, eagle is such a wonderful bird. And I came across wonderful things about the eagle. Amen.
Amen.
So I thought, wow. You know, God likened his children to eagles, and there was such a deep meaning in the eagle. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. So for the inspiration, we're going to take the inspiration more than a conqueror. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Because we realize that we have to conquer.
Amen.
Amen. And to conquer, you have to be in God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You have to be in God. You have to be serving God. Amen. And
Amen.
We know that we don't serve God by carnal understanding. We serve God by revelation. Hallelujah.
That's right.
You know, in the beginning when Adam was sleeping and God made Eve, when she stood there, Adam identified and said, bone of my bone, flesh of my flesh. But Eve could have questioned that and said, but why do you say I'm bone of your bones? Then Adam will probably start explaining, yeah, but because of you come from a rib. And Eve will ask, but what do you mean I come from a rib? How can a big body like this come from a small rib like that? You know, that she could question the word. Then Adam will try to explain and say, but yeah, what do you mean? Because you say that God never created a soul for me. God never created a spirit for me. Because we know God created a spirit and a soul for Adam. And a body for Adam. Everything else that Eve was comes from Adam. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, in the Bible, where Eve questioned even one way. So by revelation she believed.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. That she came from her because she did not know her identity.
Amen.
Adam identified her, and by revelation she believed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we did not know ourselves. We did not have identity.
Amen.
God identified us through the message of the hour.
Amen.
And by faith we believe.
Hallelujah.
So the bride does not question the way.
Amen.
The bride believes the way by revelation.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The bride believed the way by faith.
Amen.
So Brother Branham says, the devil, he was actually praying for his sister. And he said to that sister, as he gets to that sister, it was a prayer line. He prayed for one person, then the sister came. Before he prayed for that sister, he said, you devil, leave the faith of that sister.
Amen.
You see, the devil tries to get a hold of your faith because he knows that once he gets hold of your faith, he weakens you. And once he weakens you, he conquers you.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Right.
And once you are conquered, then you are done.
Mm.
So, and the devil has his silk tactics to conquer us.
Mm.
You know, the devil won't necessarily destroy you at a go. The devil will get hold of your faith. He will weaken your faith. And some of the strategies he uses to weaken your faith is television, is hanging around bad company, is saying bad things, not committing to the word, not reading, not listening to the tapes. Those things, they weaken your faith.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And once he captures your faith and your faith is weak, he's done with you.
Amen.
As long as you're a wicked Christian, the devil is happy.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because he knows that a Christian was made to conquer.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Our father Adam conquered.
Mm-hmm.
Our father Abraham conquered.
Hallelujah.
Our father Paul conquered. And we are the descendants of Paul. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We should be conquering. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. How many feels like the mother conqueror this morning?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
How many feel conquered by the trials of the week this week? So you come energized and victorious. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. You know, we come to the house of the Lord to just reflect. I'm telling you, the challenges that we meet at work, the things we see, you just need to refuel at times. Any car cannot drive without refueling. Hallelujah. Otherwise, you're stuck on the way. Amen. And when we come to the house of the Lord, you know the way is wonderful. When we come to the under the light of the way, it's just like in the army. In the army, every time you navigate yourself through the bushes, when you feel like I'm not on the right track or you feel like I'm getting lost, you do simple things. You stop, you take your map, you take your compass, then you align them. After you align them, then you look at the surroundings. You identify some things and look them in the way. Identify them. Now, if you, in the map, I mean, sorry. Now, if you identify things in the map that are not around your surrounding, it means that you are lost.
Yeah.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when you realize or discover that you're lost, there are two things that you do. One is either you backtrack and go to the spot where you remember last time finding the correct direction.
Yeah.
If you cannot backtrack or go to that spot, you do the second option. You stand still. And when you stand still, what you do, you call the headquarters and tell them, listen, I'm Commander So-and-so, me and my platoon is lost in such coordinates. Then they come to rescue you. But now, when they come, they must be able to identify you because they'll come using a chopper.
Hallelujah.
So what the hair that we wear, they've got orange things inside.
Yeah.
So we are told that when you expect the chopper to see you, you just flip the head and the orange part becomes outside.
Alright.
So that the pilot can see that there are our members there.
Yes, yes.
They can learn this.
Amen.
So the same thing with the word.
Amen.
When you see that things that Malachi said, the way you're supposed to live, you're not living, you stop.
Amen.
And take out your map, which is the Bible.
Amen.
Take out your compass, which is the spoken word.
Amen.
And align them.
Amen.
Amen.
And if you find that, you know what, there's something that I missed.
Yeah.
I cannot go forward because I've lied there.
Yeah.
I cannot go forward because I've done such and such a person wrong. Then you backtrack and go and confess.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You recall, you try to backtrack to the last spot where you were right.
Amen.
But if you see that, you know what, I cannot remember any time where I've done anyone no harm. Then you say, Lord, I cannot go far because I cannot orientate myself.
Amen.
You call the headquarters.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
You go down on your knees and call the headquarters.
Amen.
My Lord, I'm lost.
Amen.
I'm weak spiritually.
Yes.
I cannot go forward.
Amen.
Lord, I need your divine intervention. Amen.
Amen.
And when you stand there, the orange thing, you lift your hands to identify yourself.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So I'm telling you, I find very, very relevant in this good Christian life. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
So, Brother Brian speaks about an eagle. He said the eagle means the one that filled with a pig. Hallelujah. And amazingly, there are over 40 species of eagles. Imagine, over 40 species of eagle. But Brother Brian touches this one, bald eagle. He said this bald eagle. I was just amazed when Brother Brown speaks about the length of the wings and even the size of that eagle. He said the length of that of the wings is 14 inches long. 14 inches long. Speaking under correction. And when I calculated that in meters, what he said, it was about 3 meters.
That's right.
Imagine 3 meters. So now something about the eagle. The eagle is the bird of height. The eagle does not stay here on the ground. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The eagle built its nest on 2 places.
Hallelujah.
It's either on the peak of the mountain, on the rock, or at the on the peak of the tallest tree.
Amen.
On the strongest branches. Yes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And brothers, that type of the church, that type of believer. A believer's dwelling is not here amongst the world.
No.
But the believer must be upon the revelation.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But the rock type the revelation.
Amen.
Now, an egg when it gives birth, it's not like the chicken. The chicken can lay an egg every day.
Amen.
One egg every day, 24/7.
Mm-hmm.
But an egg lays 2 to maximum of 3 eggs.
Amen.
Only, and it takes over a month to sit on those eggs and give warmth to them.
Okay.
But a chicken can just hatch like this and sit on top of all of them and give birth within a week or two. So Brother Branham says we are not chickens,
but
we are eagles.
Amen.
That's why you see with this message you testify to one person. Why? In a million accept. One in a million accept.
Yes.
But the denomination that multiplying like this, like they're making photocopies.
They're
just like that.
Yeah.
It's the nature of a chicken.
Ah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But I'm saying, make no mistake, a chicken is also a bird.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
But a chicken is a bird that is earthly bound.
Oh.
A chicken is a bird that gives birth at a very fast rate.
Yeah.
But the faster rate that it gives birth, the chances of those kids surviving is half of them or quarter of them.
Yeah.
The rest will die after it hatch.
Mm-hmm.
But an eagle lays 2 to 3. And it's unlikely that one will die out of those 3.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you realize that it's not the quantity, but it's the quality.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So now when the eagles lay those eggs, it will sit on top of them.
Amen.
And when I was watching this documentary, they say they will change around the husband and the wife until all those four weeks or 40 days has passed. It will change before the eggs hatch. So you see right there, God has brooded over us and was looking after us even before you were born.
Amen.
Even before you became a message believer.
Amen.
God was warming you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why you see Brother Branham says we never even chose where we want to be.
Amen.
We never even chose the color of our skin. We never chose the family. We never chose anything. It was God who did the preparations.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And you realize, you look at your life, you realize that your life is supernatural.
Yeah.
You realize how you survived the things that people could not survive.
Yes.
Amen.
You realize that God was with you even before you came in this message.
Amen.
Because you do not become part of God and accept the message.
Amen.
But you become part of God before time begins.
Yes.
When you were, when you came here on earth, you came having a portion of God in you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you do not assume the message believer when you preach to you and you repented.
Oh, yes.
No, sir. You did not become a message believer when you stopped wearing trousers and started wearing skirts.
Oh, yeah.
Brother, you did not become a message believer when you stopped wearing shorts and started wearing long trousers.
Yeah.
You were part of God before time began.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And you will see that character by the way you respond to the word.
Yes.
But brother, in the message, how to overcome, you say, how do you know if you are no overcomer? Your attitude towards the way.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Right.
In another message, Brother Branham says, what? If you want to know that you've got the Holy Spirit, before I come to that, Brother Branham, his sister said to him, Brother Branham, this sister was a total unbeliever, sister of a brother, speaking of correction, a total, complete unbeliever. So it happened that one of the ministers preached to him or her, and she repented. So now, she did not feel like she repented. She was not sure if she repented. And she went to different ministers. She went to Billy Graham. She went to them. Another one spoke, told him that you have to speak in tongues. Another one told him that you have to do this and that. But when he came to Brother Branham, he said, "Brother Branham, I don't know if I got it. I don't know if I really repented." Brother Branham gave him a simple recipe. You know those things that people make them so complicated that it's really simple.
That's right.
Brother Branham gave him a simple recipe.
Yeah.
He said, "Sister, did you care about God before?" He said, "No." "But now, do you care about God now?" He said, "Very much. That's why I'm so concerned if I'm really repented." He said, "Then you are repentant."
Hallelujah.
Right.
For the fact that you worry so much, you care so much, it's a sign that you're not what you used to be.
Amen.
The old person who didn't worry,
yeah,
will just do wrong things and carry on.
Yeah.
But for the fact that you worry, it's a sign that you repent. Another one came to Brother Branham and said, "Brother Branham, how can I know if I've got the Holy Ghost?" In fact, no one asked Brother Branham. Brother Branham said, "You know what? One of the signs that you have the Holy Ghost is that is when you do something wrong and you feel so guilty and condemned.
Yes.
It's a sign that you've got the Holy Ghost.
Right.
Once you do something wrong and you don't feel condemned, you are free. You must get one."
Yeah.
Brother one olivella, some things more, screening, television, filthy things, one olivella marker and associated with all those things, and just feel free. You must really be one.
Yes.
Yes.
But when you do wrong and you're condemned,
yes, amen,
then you know that you've got the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And let me tell you, you know, all the things that we do naturally, wrong or right, they've got spiritual implications.
Yes. Amen. Amen.
Things that we do naturally, they've got spiritual implications.
Right.
And things that appear naturally also that we face, they've got spiritual outcome. Abraham, when the angels came, they came naturally.
Amen.
Before they came, the challenges that he went through were natural challenges.
Amen.
But it was for the spiritual promise.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So you sin natural, but spiritually someone dies in the church.
Hallelujah.
You eat communion naturally, knowing that your life is not right. Then someone spiritually dies in the church. So one of the things, characteristics of an eagle, is that an eagle has a good eyesight.
Yes.
An eagle's eyesight is not limited by range.
Mm.
So a believer's sight must not be limited by range.
Hallelujah.
So when a believer, you don't look at things for today.
You know.
You don't look at things for tomorrow.
Right.
But you look far and already see the outcome.
Yes.
And try to avoid it now. Because some of these things we get ourselves into, we are like, "Eish, I could have avoided that time." So one of the eagle's ability is to see far.
Amen.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And an eagle, when it wants to get its prey, it just flies very high. The higher it goes, the bigger range it has.
Hallelujah. Amen.
You know, when you shoot in the army, the R4 has two sides. So this one at the back has two hooks. The other one lies flat when the other one stands up. So this one that's standing up is the one that you're gonna aim through. The one that is lying down is the one that you, the other one is 300, the one lying down is 500. So if they say you're going to shoot 300 meters, then you lie the one of 500 and leave the one of 300. If they say we're gonna shoot 500, which we seldom do, we really do, you're gonna lie the one of 300 down and leave the one of 500.
Yeah.
So the range that you're gonna shoot will be determined by the capability of that weapon and the size that is up.
Okay.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So a maximum range of R4 is 500, but the effective range of R4 is 300.
That's
right. So it has some limitations.
Yeah.
But now, a faith of a believer,
Yeah.
It only needs to be this small.
Hallelujah.
Yes. Small as a mustard seed.
Yes.
He does not have limitations.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
As small as mustard seed.
Mm.
It does not have limitations. So a Christian should have a range, a bigger range.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Even naturally in your family. When you marry, you must have a bigger range. You must be planning already that I'm going to have 3 kids. This is what I'm going to do. Even after marriage, financially, you must be having a bigger range.
Yes, that's right.
With kids, the plan, you must be having a bigger range. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because the message of the hour, I believe, is the wisdom of God to us.
Amen.
And the wisdom of God to us is not just wisdom on the word, but it's wisdom also with the challenges of this life.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we use the word to conquer.
That's right.
Just like Jesus used the word to conquer.
Yes.
Brother says Moses had the rod. And everything that he did using that rod. When he divided the Red Sea, he used the rod. When he spoke the flesh into existence, when he turned the rod into snake, it was the rod. He said, but we have the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The Bible says, whatever you do in deed and in words, you do it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen. So we have to conquer.
Mm.
An eagle is a bear of conquering.
Amen.
An eagle has so much confidence in its wings.
Amen.
That's one thing for sure.
Amen.
Abraham says, an eagle in itself is not so big. But what makes it you, not Abraham, but that documentary, what makes it huge is the size of its wings.
Yeah.
And Brother Bram tells the story. He said, one day I was looking at this eagle, and this eagle was sitting there. And I thought to myself, why is this eagle not running away or scared of me? Isn't he scared that I can take my rifle and just shoot it? He said, then I saw doing the wings like this. I said, oh, he's telling me that the time I get to my rifle, it will be long for it. It has confidence in those wings. Hallelujah. So, Brother says the wings type the Bible, the Old Testament and the New Testament. So, you must just put the wings in action. That's what you must do. And now, the eagle is more stronger in the wings, it's more effective in the wings. Now, we Christians, we don't want winds and storms. Once you have a small storm, you complain and cry. If not you, who must it be? When I lose money, this one is over. So you should rejoice, because the more you get into challenges and storms and trials, that's the more problems says you put your faith into action.
Amen.
You must put those things into action.
Yeah.
Problem says that those little eaglets in the nest, he said they are so comfortable and relaxed. They are just fed by the mother every time.
Hallelujah.
He said, but it comes a time when the comfort has to end.
Yes.
Amen.
So God has to stir the nest.
That's right.
Amen. You see, it's nice here. Problem says God has to stir the nest of every church.
Hallelujah.
And just put emphasis on the denomination.
Amen.
But it started by saying every church.
Amen.
Every family. Brother Morgan, I'm telling you, after a nest in your house and children and sister, God has a nest.
Yeah. Okay.
It's not that you are not loving or you are not caring. It's God still in the nest.
Amen.
Even in the church, it cannot be honeymoon forever.
Okay.
I assume it's over one way. Summer one way. We're not like in a walk. It cannot be. So there comes a time where God stirs the nest. But when you stir the nest, your problem is those little eaglets, when the mother eagle starts to stir the nest, she'll fly high and spread the wings.
Amen.
And the little eaglets will smile in amusement and say, wow, mommy, you've got such capabilities.
Amen.
Amen. Even though they don't know what's coming their way.
Yes.
Amen.
But for the fact that the mother eagle has spread the wings.
Yes.
Yes.
Amen.
It gives them so much confidence.
Mm-hmm.
And the mother eagle will flip the wings once, and nothing will happen first time. You see, when he does that, those little eaglets remember the lot of feathers.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Brother Branham says some are strong, some are weak. So he wants those weak ones to go off.
Yes. Hallelujah.
The weak fellas must go off.
Yes.
So in the church, the weak fellas must go off. The bad habits must go off.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah.
So as it flips, make a huge air. Those fellas will fall off and fly off.
Amen.
And eventually, when that happens, then also the sheepskin or the lambskin will fly off. And those eagle will be restless there now. They will be poked when they try to see, they will be poked, they won't have anywhere to see. It's just trial after trial, challenge after challenge. But I'm telling you, the more they do this and this, jump around, the better they get in it.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Maybe they look up and say, Mama, is it all the wind you can blow? Then Mama said, no. Let me show you, and blows more. And they jump around and tumble in the nest. And the nest of an eagle is so big that they won't fall.
Amen.
Amen.
It's very, very big, because remember, an eagle built a nest once. And for the whole year, every time you just go get sticks and air on that nest. So that nest ends up being so strong and so big that whatever happens, those little eaglets will never fall.
Yeah.
And that nest is on top of the rock. So my brother, you are on the nest of God, on top of the revelation. So no matter the challenge, no matter the temptations, no matter the wind, you will never fall.
Amen. Amen. Right.
They're just there to improve you. They're just there to sharpen you.
Mm.
They're just there to take you to another level.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So those fellas, loose fellas must fall. Don't panic. Paul said, I give glory in my infirmities.
Amen.
He rejoices in his trials because they are precious than gold.
Amen.
Brother Branham make a strong statement and say, if you don't have challenges, you must pray God that He gives them to you.
That's right.
Imagine praying, God, give me challenges.
Yeah.
Most of the time, the nature of a man is God take them away.
Yes.
But the prophet says, you pray that He gives them to you.
Yeah.
Because the more challenges you get, it's just like at work. The more you do something, you become better at it. You eventually master it.
Yes, right.
Even at school, wherever you study, you start struggling. But the more you do it, you get better at it.
Hallelujah.
You master it during the exam, you pass it.
Amen.
So that's what the challenge does to you.
That's right.
You must conquer.
Amen.
And Brother Branham gives us a simple recipe to conquer. Let me read this recipe for you.
He said, brother, let's get purple inside the veil. That's right. You want to know the little secret? That's how I conquer wild animals. That's how I conquer diseases, is by love.
Hallelujah.
The love of God constrains us to do such things. Come in the veil. Want to today, while we bow our heads. So in another quote, Brother Branham says, I do not conquer demons by going around kicking them and all those things. He said, I conquer them by love.
Amen.
Have you ever thought that love can conquer?
Amen.
How did Jesus conquer the devil? Jesus never retaliated with the devil.
But when the devil comes, before even our heart, hey, we want to look at our heart. That's not how you conquer the enemy.
Yeah.
The enemy has our heart deliberately. Then Aaron went on a little. Oh, God bless you. That's how you conquer your enemy. You don't conquer the enemy by fighting. No. If you want to conquer your enemy, love the enemy, love his children.
Yes.
Amen.
But Brandon says, do go to someone who will go all out to do bad to you. Until you do that, you must know that you've got a long way to go.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Man. Right?
Imagine Brother Brandon giving us a test to say, what will you do if you come home and you find another man with a woman?
Oh,
my. But genuine agape love will forgive that person.
Amen.
I'm telling you, that is not easy. We are preaching it here as if it's easy.
Yeah.
It's not easy.
Mm-mm.
But that's the test of the genuine love that is in you.
Yeah.
Abraham conquered his enemies by love.
Right.
Until his son, Paul said, you know what, I've seen everything about the Father, but if there's one thing that I could not understand, that I find amazing about my Father, is that I could not tell the difference between his friends and enemies. Because he loved them the same and he treated them the same.
Yeah. Amen.
So to conquer, you must use the secret recipe of Brother Brenner.
Amen.
So we've got a nature of love those who love you and put away those who don't care about you.
Yeah.
Those who love you, you don't love them. If they love you, you're just reflecting their love back. But the genuine love is when you love that one who does not love you.
Yes, amen.
As a papa, I didn't too.
Yeah.
Rasanjo, or at least someone or what's how well are you feeling? Imagine. On normal circumstances, Brahma, I thought the wrong way to sleep. In normal circumstances. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
It's wonderful to serve the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Brother Graham says you have never come to contact. You will never come in contact with greater force in life than love.
Amen.
He said that in the message, hidden life in Christ. He said, yes, sir. I do not try to conquer demons by kicking them.
Yeah.
I love God.
Amen.
See? Love is what God is.
Yeah.
So if you claim that you've got God but you don't have love, you still hate someone else at the back of your mind, you don't have God.
That's right.
Because God is love.
Amen.
Amen.
So that's why we don't encourage people to marry before they accept God.
Mm.
Because God is love.
Yeah.
So you cannot claim that you love your wife if you don't have God in you.
Amen.
Because the same love that you love your wife with is the projection of the love of God.
Hallelujah.
That God, no matter how many times your wife loves you, you continuously forgive it.
Yes.
No matter how many times she wrongs you, you continuously forgive it. Because you are reflecting the love of God in you.
Amen.
God is love.
Amen.
So that's why these unbelievers, when they come to you with relationship challenges, it's difficult to advise them.
Yeah.
Because you advise them, this one is fine, they will overcome it, they will come another one.
That's right.
They will come to you for advice. You advise them, then so on and so on, it won't stop.
Yeah.
Because their love is built upon the wrong foundation.
Yes.
Their love is just filial love in isolation.
Yeah.
Emotional love. Feelings love. I love you because you got long hair. I love you because you got long skirt. I love you because you're yellow bone. Then when I saw you become a black bone, then I don't love you.
Hey.
It will be just filial love. But when you've got God in you, it's more than filial love.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, tomorrow if my wife gets in an accident and her body dislocated, she, I must still love her.
Amen.
The same way I loved her when she was wearing size 32. And if she can wake up wearing size 39 or 40, I must still love her.
Amen.
The same way when she was wearing size 28.
Amen.
The love of a child of God is not conditional.
Amen.
I'm not saying the sisters must go and get fed.
Hey.
I'm just showing an example of human life.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You love her regardless, and she loves you regardless.
Amen.
No matter how many times you wrong her, she still loves you.
Amen.
Because that is the character of Jesus Christ.
Yes,
amen.
Brothers, Jesus Christ was the perfect representation of love that ever hit the earth.
Yes,
he said, yet he was the most hated.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's right.
You see, he was the perfect representation of love. Mm. Imagine when that Roman soldier spit on the master, the king himself. Emotional Peter stood up and jumped and took the sword and said, what? And remember, that time Peter did not have the Holy Ghost. So Peter did not have God. Peter only knew God by flesh. He was walking with him. He was talking to him. He knew him by flesh. He did not know him by revelation. Remember, we spoke about that last time. So even when he cut that Roman soldier's ear, it was because of he knew him by flesh. This is my flesh brother. You cannot do that to him. But when Peter repented, and now because of the Holy Spirit that was in him, it was God in him, knew Jesus Christ not by flesh anymore, but by revelation. After he cut that man's ear, Jesus takes it and says, no, Peter, that is not love. But you don't understand, I don't worry, you will understand it after you get the upper room experience. So for now, let's fix this ear.
Yeah.
He put it back. Someone who just spit upon you. Imagine. Someone who was strategically planning to sell you out and get you crucified, Judas. Sat with him down, washed his feet, gave him a kiss and said, God bless you,
my brother.
You know, it's one thing. We don't know one another here. We don't know the seed, who's not the seed. So sometimes I'll say, God bless you. I don't know if you're Judas or not. But he knew.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes. Amen.
He knew. You know, people say we message believers, we say rough things or hard things when we pray. Okay, even message believers. Some message believers, they say, no, but when you stand behind the pulpit, you are talking to the bride of Christ. You must respect the prayer of Christ.
Yeah.
You know, don't be so harsh on them. You know the man who came to introduce this Munyadiwa to Christ, how did he speak? You must go and listen to that message, how to overcome.
Yes, sir.
When he speaks about women that put makeup, he said, well, there's one woman that put makeup in the Bible, and that was Jezebel.
Yeah, hallelujah.
And when Jezebel, and you know what happened to Jezebel? God fed her to the dogs. He said, so every woman that put those things in dog meat.
Yo.
Yeah.
Now, that is the man that introduced you to the bridegroom.
Yeah.
Who says those things? And you don't even normally preach those things.
Yeah.
In another message, you say, when you greet her, you say, hello, Mrs. Dog Meat. But he was a prophet. Amen.
That's right.
He said the reason you've got weak pulpits is because of the weak ministers that stand behind the pulpit. And once you've got weak pulpits, then you've got weak people. That's why now you get the congregation conquered every time. Because the devil has mingled himself on the pulpit. Amen. But we thank God that they can still be the bride in the midst of all those chaos. That will stand by the word and preach the word in season and out of season. Hallelujah. Amen. So, you know, an eagle, after it gives birth, it takes those children to trials. Abraham says it prepares those children for the real world. And there will come a time where it feed the little eaglets, and they will tire. Come a time where it stops. And there's something before I'm going to forget, it just came. An eagle is the only type of species that does not migrate because of weather. It only migrates because of food. Not weather. Food. So now, a Christian should not move where they are because of circumstances are not conducive for them. Remember, weather types trials.
Amen.
So when trials come, wherever you are, you remain there.
Yeah.
The only time you move, you must change church, you must change your fellowship, is when the weight is compromised. Food.
Amen.
Amen.
That's the only time you should move. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But when the weather changes, eagle doesn't move because of weather. When I went through trials and you feel like the believers are not giving you enough attention, then you think somewhere else will give you attention. You'll be shocked.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So now an eagle, it prepares them for the trials. After it prepares them, it feeds them until they become of, so they say 12 weeks. After 12 weeks, they teach them to feed themselves.
Hallelujah.
How do they teach them? The mother eagle will that day from that morning not go and hunt for them.
Yeah.
Or they'll just go out and come back with nothing.
Yeah.
And the little eagle will scream, will scream, will scream, and that mother eagle will come to the nest and fly out. What is saying to the little eagle is say, follow me. I want to go and teach you. And the little eagle will start by being stubborn because he doesn't fully understand why mom out of a sudden stopped feeding me. Mom is preparing you for the real world. So the same thing in Christianity, the same thing when you accept the message. You sit down, we teach you. Before you get mature, you don't come and preach for us.
Yeah, that's right.
You sit down, you get taught. After you get taught, they're going to come at high. Where you're on your own.
Amen.
And I'm telling you, when you're on your own, that's where the serious challenges come.
That's right.
You know, every day when you're having fellowship is nice, it's time for growth, it's feeding time. Having fellowship now and then, you feel stronger than anything. Just be exposed alone.
Yes, sir.
When we're in a group, everyone is a conqueror.
Yeah.
Everyone is an overcomer. Everyone has a testimony. Just take one individual and put him there.
Yeah.
Now you're vulnerable. Now you're on your own.
Yeah.
So the mother eagle prepares the little eaglets for such.
Yes.
Yes. Basically, those little eaglets, they stay not far from the nest. Even after they start hunting for themselves, they don't stay far from the nest for almost a year or plus. So that's why after you accept the message, you don't stay far from the Christ, you don't stay far from us. We must equip you and feed you until you are ready for the outside world.
Hallelujah.
And sometimes you leave here not being ready, you're going to come here with strange doctrine one day when you come back. Like what happened to one of our brothers. He was just sending everyone messages of strange doctrine.
Yeah.
It's because he did not take time to be fed.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yeah. Now in my mind, I thought I'm going to preach 45 minutes. Maybe we'll continue on this story of an eagle. Because it's quite interesting. I haven't spoken about the life of an eagle, I haven't spoken about the food. So one thing good about an eagle, Abraham says an eagle, well, the reason it built the nest there in the air or at the peak of the mountain is that no snakes must get to the nest. And also, it's a bit natural of heights. So in its nature. So a Christian is not ground bound. Brother Bram says we cannot be bound by the things of this world.
Amen.
Because we are eagles, we are heavenly bound.
Amen.
So we must fly high in the skies and feast upon the revelation of this day. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because we are living in the last days in the most terrible time.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Now, the life of an eagle, we know that the eagle renews his life.
We know that the eagle, when it's old, it can renew its life. Hallelujah. Rabbi speaks about that eagle going and hitting itself against the rock until all the old feathers falls off. It goes and hits the nails and flies into the sun until the layers of the ice fall off. So by doing that, it renews itself. And eagle is a wonderful bird. Solomon, when he spoke about the eagle, he did not understand it. Solomon did not understand it in the book of Proverbs chapter 30. He said there are three things that are wonderful that I do not understand. He said the way of an eagle in the air. The way of a serpent on the rock. The serpent with the revelation is very dangerous. The serpent on the rock. Very, 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 very dangerous. Because it can easily attack you. That is some of the people that come in the message, receive the revelation, and do that serpent go out. Tomorrow they come and want to attack. Is the way of a serpent upon the rock. Solomon did not understand. But we thank God for the messenger who came and explained. And he did not understand the movement of an eagle in the air.
Amen.
How the eagle, when everybody is running away from the storm, he flies against the storm. How the eagle just flapped the wings wide and just swayed in those storms.
Yeah.
He wondered, what manner of bird is this one?
Amen.
When the chickens are running away from the storm, crying about the storm, and eagle is feasting in the storm, in the challenges. So we are not eagles. Brother says eagles eat special type of meat. But something about chickens is that chickens can eat eagle food and chicken food. But an eagle cannot eat chicken food. Chicken can eat both. But eagle eat only eagle food. So a Christian must only eat Christian food, which is the spoken word of this hour.
Yes, sir.
That is the revealed word of the hour.
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Remember, the church is built upon the revelation of the word. Upon this rock I will build my church.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
The church of Cain was built on the ground. The church of Balaam was built on the ground. The church of Lord was built on the ground.
Amen.
The church of the Pharisees was built on the ground. The church of Romans was built on the ground. But the church of Abel was built upon the rock.
Amen.
The church of Abraham was built upon the rock.
Amen.
The church of Peter was built upon the rock.
Amen.
The church of Paul was built upon the rock.
Amen.
The church of Pentecost upon the rock. And the bride must be built upon the rock.
Amen.
Amen.
No shortcut. Hallelujah. And we are not talking about the funny types of rocks.
Rich.
No, there are a lot of rocks. I'm telling you. We are speaking about the genuine rock, the message of the hour. Hallelujah. So as we're going to go into prayer meeting, let's just remember that to conquer, you have to love. You need love to conquer. Some of you have demons in your life. Demons, people are thinking about these strange creatures. No, your bad habits are demons.
Yes. Yeah, that's right.
Some of you have demons of being unable to forgive. Some of you have demons of short temper. Short temper is a demon. The Bible teaches us that we should have long hearts.
Amen.
Temper is a demon. Because what temper does, it makes you to react without thinking and regret later.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
So Brother Brown says, love conquers demons.
That's right.
So we have to exercise holiness.
Amen.
We have to exercise godliness.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Remember that scripture where I think it's Paul saying the exercising of the body profiteth nothing.
That's right.
And when you continue to say, but the rather exercise godliness.
Amen.
Amen.
So godliness is not something that you master in one day. It's something that you have to exercise on a daily basis. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So God bless you.
Amen.
Thanking you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen.